Live from the Veterans Coliseum in Phoenix, Arizona, it's the Salt Lake Golden Eagles and the Phoenix Roadrunners. Hi, everybody, and welcome to the Veterans Coliseum in Phoenix, where tonight the Salt Lake Golden Eagles take on the Phoenix Roadrunners. I'm Mike Barak, and alongside a gentleman that played with the Salt Lake Golden Eagles, and joining me in the broadcast tonight is Randy Busick. And Randy, boy, it's fun. We're here in Phoenix, and big game here tonight, the Eagles and the Runners.
Well, no question about that, Mike. Every time these two teams get together, they always have a fast-paced, rough-and-tumble style of game. And with both teams trying to climb up in the standings, we expect much of the same tonight.
And they have a great crowd expected here tonight for the Eagles and the Roadrunners. And Randy, one of the keys to the game tonight will be the star center iceman, Sean Hafey for Salt Lake.
Well, Sean's coming off of a big week. He scored 7 points in one game against San Diego, and those efforts earned him the IHL Player of the Week. If he continues on that pace, he'll definitely be a factor in tonight's game.
One of the players the Eagles have to watch out for is a gentleman that scored 50 goals last year in the IHL, Sylvain Couturier.
Well, he had a super season here last year and had a great training camp up in L.A., earned himself a spot, recently sent down, and the Roadrunners are going to look to him for a lot of leadership tonight.
Well, a new feature in our broadcast, we have the Franklin Game Planner. And Randy Busick, what are some of the keys for the game tonight?
Well, one of the big keys is a discipline among the teams. When they play each other so often in a season, a lot of animosity and high emotions take over. The team that's able to harness those emotions and stay out of the penalty box is going to have the best chance to win tonight.
And the goaltending situation for Salt Lake, Jason Mazzotti, the expected starter, and some changes with the Roadrunners.
Well, Ralph Backstrom loses his number one goaltender, David Goverdy, up to L.A., was forced to put in Gilmore, whereas Bobby Francis has two great goaltenders behind him. He chooses Jason Mazzotti, currently second-best average in the league.
Well, it should be fun tonight. The Eagles and the Roadrunners from the Veterans Coliseum here in Phoenix. We'll have play-by-play action, the Eagles and the Roadrunners, in just a moment. Can you hear me? Okay. Did they? When we watched that, it didn't have the.
Okay. Nice and fit above with the beanie on, the black and white shirt.
Wow.
That's not a big deal. It still look good.
Yep. Okay. I didn't blink again. I noticed that. Gotta blink. Gotta blink a little bit more.
Take the cardboard out of your shirt. They're on the ice. They're coming out right now. Oh, he keeps cutting in and out. Well, that's all right.
Give the Roadrunner.
Do you need that still? Do you need that? You need that still?
I need it.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to the Veterans Coliseum in Phoenix, Arizona, where the Salt Lake Golden Eagles prepare to take on their Western Division rival, the Phoenix Roadrunners. And Randy Busick, former Golden Eagle player, has joined us in the broadcast tonight. I'm Mike Barak, and Randy, they expect a great crowd, nearly 9,000 for the game tonight, and we should have a fabulous hockey game.
Well, there's no question about that, Mike. Every time that Salt Lake comes into town, it really stirs up a lot of interest among the people here, and they're expecting at least 9,500 fans tonight, and they could become a big factor in the game.
Tonight's lineups are brought to you by Blue Cross and Blue Shield. For 50 years, Blue Cross and Blue Shield has been Utah's favorite color of insurance. Jason Mazzotti opposes Daryl Gilmore. Daryl Olson and Kevin Grant on defense. Up front, Sean Hafey centering Tim Harris and Todd Struby. Rene Chapdelaine and Chris Norton on defense for the Phoenix Roadrunners, and Scott Bukestead along with Francis Breaux and a 50-goal scorer from last year's Sylvain Couturier on the wings for the Phoenix Roadrunners. As the Golden Eagles on the ice along with the Roadrunners, a look at Sean Hafey, who had a 7-point performance last week, and the starting goaltender tonight for the Salt Lake Golden Eagles, 21-year-old Jason Mazzotti.
Well, he's a big key right now on the Golden Eagles. He's played super for Bobby Francis and had actually a great campaign as a rookie going so far, and hopefully he can continue on his ways tonight.
The Golden Eagles have not beaten the Phoenix Roadrunners in 9 straight games, 5 in the regular season this year, 4 straight. The Eagles bowed out to Phoenix in postseason play last year. So the Eagles are very well aware that they have not beaten the Roadrunners this season and look forward to their first 2-point effort against Phoenix in 1991-92.
No question about that, Mike. It's been quite a roller coaster season for the Golden Eagles, but the biggest thorn in their side so far this year has been the Phoenix Roadrunners.
A look at the Veterans Coliseum, the same building that houses the Phoenix Suns of the National Basketball Association, as they list the starting lineups on the ice for the fans here in Phoenix. The Eagles, Sean Hafey, and boy, he is red hot. 9 points in his last 2 games, and he finished just 1 point shy of the franchise record with 7 in a game against San Diego last week. And he's out there to start here tonight, Randy, and a real force for Salt Lake. He could be one of the keys offensively for the Eagles, which will be touched on our open here tonight.
Well, there's no question about that. Between call-ups and injuries and whatnot, the Golden Eagles have been shorthanded, but Hafey's really stepped forward to lead the team in points.
Now they're announcing the starting lineups for the fans here in Phoenix. The Phoenix Roadrunners with their goaltender, Daryl Gilmore, is the starter here this evening. Their backup goaltender tonight is their trainer. David Goverdi was called up to the Los Angeles Kings and played last night. A look at the 24-year-old Winnipeg native, Daryl Gilmore, who tonight will play in his 18th game of the season and 2nd against the Salt Lake Golden Eagles this year.
Well, you said that their trainer is their backup goalie, and I'm sure that Ralph Backstrom was sweating in his palms. He doesn't want anything to happen to Gilmore tonight, because you certainly don't really have an option except to put in your backup goaltender, and that wouldn't be a great thing for the Phoenix Roadrunners.
Interesting enough, former Golden Eagle netminder Wayne Cowley has been added to the roster. He will join the team on this upcoming road trip, but not in action here tonight. So the Eagles and the Roadrunners prepare to battle. A great crowd here tonight at the Veterans Coliseum. But before we get to the play-by-play, let's pause for the playing of our national anthem here at the Veterans Coliseum. The Eagles prepare to take on their Western Division rivals, the Phoenix Roadrunners. And as mentioned, a tremendous crowd here tonight. Of our national anthem from the Veterans Coliseum here in Phoenix, the Eagles and the Phoenix Roadrunners. Bob Francis, head coach of the Golden Eagles, always counts the stars and stripes behind the bench, so that's his little pregame ritual.
Well, a little bit of pregame ritual exactly right, but I think he's just happy to have a full team out there. It's been quite some time since he's been able to fill all the jerseys that they have in the locker room.
16 skaters and 2 goaltenders. That's the maximum, and the Eagles at even strength tonight. The Eagles with 6 defensemen, and boy, that's a luxury. It's been 2 months since the Eagles have been able to draft 6 backliners in a game. They'll have 10 forwards and 6 defensemen here tonight against the Phoenix hockey team, and they'll have to watch out for Sylvain Couturier. He's up front tonight for the Phoenix Roadrunners on their starting forward line. The faceoff will be at center ice. The Eagles is in their red road uniforms, trimmed with white and gold. The referee tonight from Regina, Saskatchewan, Brad Watson. The linesman Don Moffitt and Gene Baskin were underway here in Phoenix. And immediately Tim Harris bumps it off the boards into the Roadrunner zone. Loose back of the goal. Sean Hafey trying to center one. Back to the defense where Kevin Grant just bumps it on the right side. And the Roadrunners come up with a puck on the far wing. Francis Breaux up the center ice for Bill O'Dwyer and across the line. And it's cleared away at the defense. Now a quick shot by the forward Bill O'Dwyer. It's taken by Mazzotti and he just falls on top. A lot of oohs and ahs from the fans here. They're on Mazzotti. They don't like the fact that he covered up just 25 seconds into the game.
Well, no question about it. They wanted him to keep that puck going in play, but that's been one of the big keys for Mazzotti, really going through this tough stretch when the defensemen were really low in numbers. He jumped on all the rebounds and all the pucks, slowed the game down, and I'm sure that Bobby Francis wants to make the Roadrunners play their pace and their style of game tonight.
Mazzotti ranked 2nd in goals against average in the IHL with a 2.85 goals against. Here's the puck loose on the right side as we're back to action. Eagles break the center and it's cleared right back in by the newcomer, Peter Kozelski. Third of the boards on the left wing side and now into the neutral zone where the rookie Kozelski gains possession for Salt Lake and clears it to the Phoenix blue line. Early on here in Phoenix, no score between the Eagles and the Roadrunners. And Jason Mazzotti himself, who loves to play the puck, able to wind it free on the right side. Phoenix take over. They try and clear to the boards behind the net. And Kevin Guy back for Salt Lake. Now, he's missed action for the past month with a pulled hamstring in his first game back since being reassigned by the Calgary Flames. Here is the former Lake Superior star, Tim Breslin, into the Salt Lake zone. Broken up with the defense. Matt scrambled along the near boards. And the Golden Eagles control the puck. Early on, here in the first period. And Tom Harkins breezing to center. The Cleveland native and across the blue line shoots one. And he just missed it center, but tipped away as Sean White controls on left wing. And White just sent down this past week by the parent Los Angeles Kings. In across the Salt Lake blue line. Couturier to drive. And he shot it wide. McDonald a point blank shot. And it's steered aside by Mazzotti. Here is the puck loose to the blue line. Clear to the side of the goal. No rolls for Salt Lake. Trying to jam it free and they freeze it to the right of the goal. A minute 43 gone into the opening period and Brad Watson's going to call our first penalty of the hockey game.
Well, that didn't take too long. Watson's going to call a high sticking penalty. Looks like it's going to go against Dennis Holland. So the Phoenix Roadrunners are going to get the first chance of the power play here tonight, Mike.
And the Roadrunners and the Eagles have struggled on the power play situations as the puck went into the corner to the right of the Salt Lake goal.
Well, Holland just tried to lift up White's stick, but his stick seemed to ride up on White's jersey and hit him in the facial area. And Watson was right there, got a good look at it, and called it down for a penalty.
Roadrunners this year ranked 10th of 10 teams, so they're the worst team in the power play at 24 for 182. Holland for high sticking, 143 the time of the penalty. Here is 30-year-old Rick Gilland shooting wide of the target. They fight for it to the right of the Salt Lake goal. Now into the slot for Francis Breaux. Shoots one, and Mazzotti falls on top of the loose puck with the quick centering pass into Salt Lake goal crease. 156 gone into the opening period. A scoreless game. Mazzotti, along with the entire Golden Eagle hockey team, looking for their first win against the Roadrunners. And a look at Ralph Backstrom and Randy Busick and Ralph Backstrom, the head coach of Phoenix, have something in common. Both have Stanley Cup rings with the Montreal Canadiens.
Well, I'm sure he's just about as proud of that as I am also, Mike.
Here's the puck loose to the top of the circle, down to the point for Lands, for Francis Breaux, able to play it to the side of the goal. It's centered in front, but just shot wide by Scott Bukestad, and he does not miss too often. Bukestad leading Phoenix in points with 27. We're in the first period. Phoenix on the power of playing this scoreless game. And Rick Lands, the former Vancouver Canuck, flips it into the Salt Lake zone. Grant for Salt Lake just clears it off the glass and all the way down.
Good job by Kevin Grant to pick up that loose puck and fire it down the ice. Of course, when you're shorthanded, there won't be an icing call.
Here's the playback of the goal, and the Roadrunners gain possession out of their own end. It's flipped into the neutral zone, and it's knocked right back into the Salt Lake territory, and the Eagles break the center. Here's Tim Harris, a long shot. That deflects wide. They fight for it back of the goal, and the defenseman Norton for Phoenix trying to dig it free. Cleared, however, by the Roadrunners all the way down into the Salt Lake zone, and Jason Mazzotti clears it up into the near side, and I believe he'll get a minor penalty. Let's see. On the near side. But before we figure out if there's a two-minute minor going to be called, we'll take a break. Scoreless here in Phoenix, and this is Golden Eagles hockey.
Oh, thanks for putting me on the spot, Mike. Yeah.
Is he going to call that?
Mm-hmm.
It didn't even go up into the stands.
It did. No one touched it.
Went into the penalty box area.
Doesn't matter. There's glass there. I'm sure it's a penalty. Yeah, there's a penalty.
Welcome back, everyone. This is Mike Barak alongside former Golden Eagle Randy Busick here at the Veterans Coliseum. The fans delighted because Jason Mazzotti tried to clear the puck into the Phoenix zone, but unfortunately cleared it up into the near side into the penalty box area, and they're going to give him a delay of the game minor.
Well, that warrants a penalty. The only way a goaltender can get away with that is if he shoots it into an area where there doesn't happen to be glass, such as the player's box, but he threw it in the area of the penalty box, and there was glass, and so that's why Watson called a penalty. Bobby Francis is arguing it, but I don't think he's going to gain any ground on this one.
Francis feels that the only way a minor penalty can be called if it directly goes up into the stands, but they're going to call a penalty in a two-man Phoenix power play here in the first period. And immediately it's Sean White on the boards on the left wing side for Phoenix, trying to work it free to the forward Karjalainen. Back to the right wing side for Rene Chapdelaine. Here is Chapdelaine, able to play it free for Couturier to the Swedish date of Karjalainen. Trying to center one, does! And it's steered aside by Mazzotti, I believe, and clear to the right wing point. Two-man power play, 5-on-3 for Phoenix. Chapdelaine to Karjalainen, and shoots! And a pad save made by Mazzotti and cleared on the right side by Salt Lake to the blue line. Karjalainen trying to hold it in, and finally it squirts to center. Forward Sean McCosh into the Salt Lake zone, trying to bump it free on the left wing boards, and the second-year pro for Salt Lake, Kevin Melrose, plays him to the right side and out to center ice. The first player back on, so the Eagles just one man short. Here's Safey, bumped hard at the blue line by Couturier, and the puck skips back to the Phoenix goal. Score of this game, 4 minutes gone into the opening period. And at his own defense is the 25-year-old Saskatchewan native. Chapdelaine plays it to the Salt Lake blue line. And finally, Grant, at his own defense, plays to center. Here's Chris Norton. Played the last three seasons in the Winnipeg Jets organization. On left wing for Francis Breaux. Breaux is tied up now, works to the top of the circle, shoots one, and Mazzotti squeezes the pads together and hold on in front with 4:21 gone into the scoreless first period. Be sure to watch Real 14 tomorrow night for live coverage of NCAA basketball as the Weber State University Wildcats host the University of Utah Running Utes at the D Event Center in Ogden. And the Wildcats take on the Nevada Reno Wolfpack Thursday, January 9th on Real 14. Game time both nights is 7:30. Real 14, we've got it. Here's the puck cleared all the way down into the Phoenix zone, and with 29 seconds left in the Mazzotti penalty, Roadrunners lose it, but here's the shot saved by Gilmore, and he holds on in front, almost a costly giveaway in the Phoenix defense.
Wow, what a golden opportunity there by Tim Harris, and I'm sure he'll be seeing that one over and over again tonight in his dreams. He was staring an open net, he spun around the net, and he just happened to hit the goalpost. I don't know how he missed that one. Here he goes, Gilmore has the puck, Harris grabs it, spins around, he has a whole open net, and he hits the goalpost. Unbelievable.
Yeah, and he had that empty side. I don't think he had a lot of time, however, and if he knew how much room he had, I think maybe he would have taken a little bit more time.
Well, the goalie goes back, and behind there, Harris could have really bumped him over, but he elected to steal the puck, and he had a great scoring opportunity.
We're back to action now. 16 seconds left in the penalty, but Salt Lake clear it all the way down, and the Roadrunners have to go back. Here's Chris Norton at his own defense, the Oakville, Ontario native, able to play the puck in his center, and Phil O'Dwyer able to work the center ice, and then on left wing, Rick Lands gains possession. Eagles ready to kill off this penalty. Olsen is back on. The Eagles have killed it off. However, it's clear to the blue line, and Chris Norton holds it in for Phoenix. Able to play it on the right side. Norton shoots one in front, but just deflected wide. And Olsen on right wing in this scoreless game. Able to bump it for Todd Harkins. Right side for the rookie Kozelski. Into the Phoenix zone for Harkins. Back of the Phoenix goal, trying to center one, but tipped away. Kozelski back of the net. Trying to feed it for Harkins, but Norton gives him a little poke check and works it free on the right side. Scoreless game here in Phoenix. The Eagles have killed off a two-man power play. Kevin Guy takes a tumble to the right of the goal. And Mazzotti himself plays it on left wing for the former San Diego goal, Dennis Holland. He is checked at center ice and cleared right back into the Salt Lake zone.
Well, good job by the Phoenix Roadrunners to box up the Golden Eagles in their own zone.
Eagles flip it to center and into the Phoenix zone. And back after it is Brent Thompson, the 20-year-old rookie for the Roadrunners. There's the center, and Holland for Salt Lake just floats it right back in to the Phoenix zone. And back after it is Brent Thompson at his own defense. Eagles change on the fly as it's worked to center ice, and Brent Thompson bear hugged by Kerry Clark, and the puck skips back of the Salt Lake goal. There's Kevin Melrose on left wing. Plays but not out, stolen in front of the goal. Quick chance by Ian Duncan, and steered aside by Mazzotti. Loose in front, and Mazzotti able to play it. Now it's clear to the blue line. Roadrunners Thompson holds it in. He flips it to the side of the net. Melrose comes up with the puck. No score here in the first period. The Eagles trying to work it free, and finally they dump it out of their own end. And the Eagles able to clear it to center. Now Phoenix dump it right back into the Salt Lake zone.
Well, Phoenix really has a lot of momentum going right now, and they're getting deep on it.
There's a quick chance in front for Kaiser Leiden, and the save made by Mazzotti. Boy, oh boy, the Eagles had possession back of the goal, and for a moment they lost possession. Kaiser Leiden was deep in the slot, and Mazzotti was able to make the stop.
Well, we're going to look at some of the rules of hockey here right now. Ardell Icing.
Both heads on the road, runners win 65, horses wins 2. Each half the runners win microwave after being donated $25. Hockey is 65, horses win week campaign. So we'll share on the road, runners.
Sponsored by Ardell Brown Recreational Vehicles. Rule number 3 is icing. Icing occurs when the puck is passed into the attacking zone and is touched by a defender after the puck passes beyond the goal line. This results in a faceoff back in the offensive team's zone. However, if a similar play is made after the passer has crossed the center line, this is a legal play, even if the puck is touched by a defender first.
Okay, and the faceoff will come all the way back. Randy, a chance for the fans to learn a little bit about this game of hockey. And just earlier, a great scoring chance for the Roadrunners.
Unbelievable. I was just about to say how what a great forecheck the Phoenix Roadrunners have going right now. And they created a great scoring opportunity off of that forecheck.
Both teams have had dandy chances here in the first period, but still no score. Here is little Sean Hafey, Salt Lake's leading point scorer, trying to sign one, does, and Tim Harris flips it wide. Loose in front, Struby scores! Todd Struby, as the puck bounced in front of the goal. And with 13 minutes left in the opening period, the Eagles strike first, 1-0 Salt Lake.
Well, what a great passing play there. Hafey throws it over to Harris. He has a great chance, but he's absolutely hauled down by Chapdelaine. The puck bounces off the boards. Gilmore's unable to get a hold of it. Struby comes rushing in, grabs it, and throws it high over top of Gilmore into the net behind. And what a big goal for the Golden Eagles. Here we are again. Just a great forecheck, and that's exactly the way the Roadrunners have gotten their opportunities so far in the game. The Eagles fight right back, and they get a good scoring chance, and they make no mistake this time, Mike.
Struby, the oldest Golden Eagle, 28 years of age, from Lanigan, Saskatchewan, his 10th of the year. Tim Harris and Sean Hafey on the assist. 1-0 Eagles in the lead. How do you like that? Here's the puck loose back of the Phoenix goal as we're back to action. Playing the Phoenix zone to the left of the goaltender Gilmore. They still try and jostle it free and finally freeze it with 7:26 gone into the opening period. Struby is 10th from Harris and Hafey. And Todd Struby has been around for a long time. A second round Edmonton pick way back in 1983. His last season of the IHL before coming back this year was in 1987-88 with the Fort Wayne Comets, and a lot of international experience with the Canadian national team.
Well, there's no question about that, Mike, and I think that's one of the main reasons why Calgary signed him, to send him down here to Salt Lake to be a veteran and a leader. He's very wily and he knows a lot of things, and he helps out the youngsters quite a bit.
Face-off will be to the left of the Phoenix goals. 12 and a half minutes left in the first period. Salt Lake jumping on top. Here's Brian Deasley, who's wearing number 45 tonight. We'll tell you about that as the evening progresses. As the Roadrunners clear to the Salt Lake blue line, and Kevin Guy
has to go back. Guy who's played three games with the Flames this year. On left wing for Tom Harkins and across the line. In for Deasley on goal. Deke shoots, he scores! Brian Deasley, what a tremendous passing play. And with 7:45 gone into the first, Deasley lights it up for a 2-0 Salt Lake lead.
I'll tell you, the Eagles are flying now. That didn't take too long. A great three-way passing play between Harkins, Kozowski, and Deasley. He makes a great move, gets Gilmore to commit himself, spins around and finds it, a little opening far on the far side and throws it behind Gilmore, and the Eagles take a big 2-0 lead.
Well, he was in tight, Randy, not a lot of room to shoot.
Well, just a great play. He got in tight, and he really took his time, made a move, and made Gilmore really go down. And once the goaltender goes down, it makes things a lot easier for the forward.
Brian Deasley's ninth of the year from Tom Harkins and Peter Kozowski. 7:45 the time of the goal. Eagles up 2-0. And they're trying to quiet down this big crowd. Here's the play on left wing, and big Darren Banks for Salt Lake rumbles on left wing. However, it's cleared by Phoenix right back into the Salt Lake zone to the right of the net. And the rookie for Salt Lake out of Division III, Springfield, Massachusetts, AIC College, Kevin Wertman on left wing for the Eagles, Kevin Melrose, who bumps it back of the net. Big Banks for Salt Lake, able to play it back of the goal. Holland centers, but tipped away as it went between the two Salt Lake defenders. Had it gone to one of the backliners, a good scoring chance would have developed for Salt Lake. Eagles early on, leading 2-0 here in Phoenix, Arizona, looking for their first win of the season against the Roadrunners. And it is Brent Thompson on left wing, able to play it free into the neutral zone for Darrell Williams. Bad scramble at center. Brent Thompson runs into Williams, and the Eagles come up with a puck. In across the line, Kevin Melrose moving in. Wrist shot, stick save by Gilmore. Here's a play to the corner. Eagles Hafey and Thompson collide. It squirts loose on right wing, and it is finally Mike Vukinich, former teammate of Kevin Melrose at Harvard, able to work it free. Here's Francis Groh into the Salt Lake zone trying to center one, but Darrell Williams out of the Ontario Hockey League unable to catch the pass, and the Eagles play the puck back of the net, and Kevin Grant gains possession. Eagles work out of their own end. Here leading 2-0, Hafey on left wing for Todd Struby, who scored the first goal. In for Hafey, in on net, poke check on the right side, and Groh leads it free for Scott Bukestead. At center ice and across the line, the Bill O'Dwyer, the former Boston Bruin, trying to work it free. It skips to the right of the Salt Lake net. It is taken by Norden. His shot to block off on left wing, and finally Struby with Salt Lake in their own side. Has no other choice but to clear at the center. And Norden bursts back the other way for Phoenix. Just flips it right back into the Salt Lake zone. And Kozowski plays the puck. Here's Peter Kozowski, who's played the last two seasons in the East Coast Hockey League, a rung below the IHL. On left wing, able to play it for Todd Harkins. His pass went for a streaking Deasley a little bit off the mark. And the Roadrunners dump the center. And Salt Lake leading 2-0 and have possession of the puck. Stolk able to wing it to center. And finally, Thompson plays the puck for Phoenix. He is draped down by Harkins in center ice. Fans looking for a penalty. But Watson watches impassively. And the fans all over the referee here on that particular play. And Harkins gains possession, whirls around at his own defense.
Well, we expected a fast-paced game, and that's exactly what we're getting here tonight, Mike.
And the Eagles clear to the Phoenix blue line. 9.5 minutes left in the first. Eagles leading by a 2-0 count. And Kiosti Kajalainen on left wing for Tim Breslin. Into the Salt Lake zone, shoots, he scores!
Dark behind him. Here's the shot. It's a good one, though, up high over the blocker, and just sneaks past Mazzotti, and the Roadrunners cut the lead in half 2-1.
Tim Breslin out of the collegiate ranks. Lake Superior, a former teammate of Tim Harris, scores a goal. It's 2-1 in favor of the Golden Eagles, and the fans delighted about that scoring play, and we'll see how this affects the game. Here's Wertman, flips it to the blue line, dumped right back to center, and Melrose for Salt Lake, bumped off, and the former runner, Clark, is checked. Phoenix take over, Couturier trying to maneuver free, but the pass a little bit off the mark. Here's the play back of the goal. Roadrunners try and work it to McDonald. Shoots! And Mazzotti gets a glove on that. Couturier to the side of the goal. Bumped off by Melrose. And a stoppage of play to the right of the Salt Lake goal. Roadrunners have cut the lead 2-1 as they were scrambling to the right of Jason Mazzotti. Kiosti Karjalainen and Brent Thompson on the assists
on that scoring play for Phoenix, and I believe we're going to have a penalty right here.
Well, Kevin Melrose is going to go into the penalty box for a high sticking call here, almost the same as what happened to Holland. He goes in against Couturier, and his stick rides up his jersey and catches Couturier high in the facial area. Watson was right there and really had no choice to call a penalty, and he elected to call a two-minute minor rather than a five-minute major. Big break for the Golden Eagles.
Kevin Melrose wearing the C tonight as the captain. Richard Zemlak, Paul Cruz, and Rich Chernomas have all worn the C, but with all three in Calgary, Bob Francis says every time he names a captain, they call him up to Calgary.
Well, it's like a lottery getting that C on your jersey. You've got to be happy to be wearing it, but definitely Bobby Francis has lost a lot of veterans up to Calgary, and I think he made a good choice on putting that C on Kevin Melrose tonight.
Melrose a high stick at 11:22. Phoenix go on the power play for the third time. They are 0-2. Here's Chapdelaine in this game with Salt Lake leading 2-1, trying to work it free, but Struby immediately dumps it down, and that's what you want to do when you're shorthanded.
Well, no question about that. Struby takes a dive there trying to get a penalty called against them and even things up, but Watson looks at it and decides not to call it.
Here is Sylvain Couturier in across the line. He scored 5 goals in a game for the Roadrunners last season, trying to work it free, but Grant for Salt Lake pounds it on the boards, but not out. Phoenix hold it in. It's dumped to the top of the circle, now to the blue line. Struby for Salt Lake trying to dig it free, but the Roadrunners come up with a puck. Here's Karjalainen at the point. In front, Couturier, loose in front, and tipped away by Salt Lake, and the Eagles just try and dump it outside the blue line, and finally they succeed.
Great play by Struby to grab that puck, make a couple of nifty moves, and throw it down and kill a little bit of time off this power play.
Just over a minute left in the power play as the Roadrunners working across the line. Francis Bro, but offside at the defense with 7:41 to go in the opening period. Struby and Deasley scoring for Salt Lake. Breslin scoring for the Roadrunners. Eagles leading by a score of 2-1. You're in Phoenix, and we'll have more play-by-play in just a moment. Mike Barak alongside Randy Busick from the Veterans Coliseum here in Phoenix. I'm glad you've joined us here tonight. We're pleased to bring the action on Channel 14 along with our Golden Eagle radio network here tonight. Here's the puck loose at center ice, and Todd Harkins dumps it to the Phoenix blue line, and Scott Bukestad gains possession. He played briefly with Salt Lake in 1983-84. Here's the puck cleared on left wing into the Salt Lake zone. It is Bill O'Dwyer alongside Francis Brault. It is a Phoenix power play for another 40 seconds as the Roadrunners have possession at the point. Here's a shot deflecting by Lance and caught by the Eagles' Mazzotti with traffic in front. And Randy, very difficult for a goaltender to see that puck come free on the power play with a lot of traffic in front of the goal.
That's exactly right, Mike, and that's one of the strategies of Ralph Backstrom is to get some of his bigger players out in front of Mazzotti. Here you can see Mazzotti has a great look at that puck and really not too much trouble, but there were people lingering around. Billy O'Dwyer looking for a rebound, wily old veteran hanging around the net.
First round Calgary pick back in 1988, the only goaltender picked in the first round that season, Jason Mazzotti. Here's Rick Lanz at the left point. On this Phoenix man advantage chance, lands to the blue line, able to play it for Francis Bro. Shoot, scores! Well, just as we talked about, if you cause a screen in front of the net, it's going to play havoc with a goaltender. I don't think Mazzotti ever saw that shot go through.
He had absolutely no chance. Unfortunately, it was Kevin Grant who went down to block that shot, and he got in the way of Jason Mazzotti being able to see that. That's when the defenseman comes out, tries to block it, but if you don't get a piece of it, it makes things tough for the goaltender. Here we have a great view of exactly what Mazzotti's looking at, and he really did not have a chance on that one, Mike.
Rick Lanz on the assists along with Billy O'Dwyer, the scorer, Francis Bro, to tie the game. So it's a power play goal, and the Roadrunners, as mentioned, have squared it up here. It's 2-2. Eagles now play it to the Phoenix blue line, and it is McDonald winds to center, and Tim Harris shoots it to the Phoenix blue line. Here's Harris on right wing, dumps it in. What a first period we've had. 4 goals, 2 for both teams.
And the Roadrunners play it, but not out. Melrose sweeps it behind the net. Struby for Salt Lake, trying to dig it free. Harris for Salt Lake. Hands it for Sean Afey. Fiddles with a puck to the point for Grant. Shoots and just deflected wide by Harris. Here's Struby for Salt Lake, as this line has been very effective. Afey with Struby and Harris. Here's the centering pass, but blocked off of the defense. And Thompson checked hard along the far side by Harris. Eagles trying to dig it free in a stoppage of play and a hand pass from one player to another into the Phoenix zone. But 6:16 to go in the first period. A 2-2 standoff. Shots on goal. 11-6 in favor of the Roadrunners.
Well, unbelievable first period so far tonight, Mike. We expected exactly this. The Eagles are hungry to get a win against the Roadrunners. And the Roadrunners, 10 points behind Salt Lake, they're desperate to climb up and catch them. And we've seen a lot of great action so far.
Four goals in the opening period. Salt Lake tonight looking to move back to the 500 mark. They're 16-17-3 on the season. They're in fourth place. And with a win tonight would even up their road record. They come into the game tonight just one under the 500 mark at 7-8-3. And it's been a wild first period. Excellent, exciting hockey here tonight. Here's the play on the right side. The Roadrunners tip it into the Salt Lake defense. And back after it is Peter Kozowski for Darren Stoke. And then Kozowski leveled back of the net, sending a rise to the Phoenix fans. Norton at center, poke check, and the Eagles break back. At center ice, Deasley is tied up. It's finally worked the center. Kozowski along with Deasley and Harkins the forward line. Kozowski now into the Phoenix zone. Stops him in the corner, trying to center one. Does, but tipped away by Norton, and the Roadrunners on the attack. Sean White on left wing for a dangerous Couturier. But back of the goal to the left of the net is Kevin Guy on left wing. Able to play it for Todd Harkins. Left side for Deasley. In across the line, but back checking for Phoenix is Scott Bukestead. Plays to center, and Kevin Melrose for Salt Lake. Ahead for Darren Banks. And he is not liked here in Phoenix. They get on him whenever he gains possession of the puck. Here is Couturier now for the Roadrunners to the right of the goal. Trying to center one. Melrose unable to gain possession. It's taken back of the goal. Bukestead centers in front. Mazzotti the save as he was down and out. Fortunately for him, it hit him. Eagles clear it all the way down and deep into the Phoenix zone. Rick lands back after it, and icing is the call. 4:57 to go in the first period. The Salt Lake Golden Eagles and the Phoenix Roadrunners tied at 2, and we'll be back with more in just a moment.
It was unbelievable. Who was the defenseman that fell on him there? Was that Kozowski or who?
It is, and it can't get much more exciting than this. It is. It is. Welcome back to Phoenix, Arizona, and for the past three seasons, whenever these two teams get together, Andy, it's been exciting hockey as we're going to take a look here to the left of the Salt Lake goal with 4:57 left, and as mentioned, exciting action when these two teams meet.
Well, I'll tell you what, you couldn't have written a better script so far for the first 15 minutes of this period. There's some hard battling out there right now.
And the teams at even strength tonight, and that's going to help as far as the finesse is concerned, and also for the physical aspect all night long as it's dumped to center. The Eagles came in here last time with 13 skaters. They were three under the limit, and they had to play a defensive style. Whenever they gained possession of the puck, they just cleared it all the way down. But when you have a full roster at 16-2, there's a lot more things you can do creatively in your own end and in the offensive zone.
Well, Bobby Francis finally has the luxury of being able to suit a full team, and he really has changed the strategy in how they're going to face up against Phoenix tonight. And they're putting together an excellent first period so far.
Eagles just one win in their last five decisions. However, they've gained points in 3 of 5 as the goaltender Bazzotti able to scoop it up and make the save in front of the Salt Lake goal. Eagles started off very poorly, Randy. Salt Lake just 1-9-1 in their first 11. They went 10-3 in the month of November. They've slowed down a bit here in the month of December, but what a turnaround after that dismal start.
They definitely have had a season full of peaks and valleys, and as you mentioned before, a very bad start, but they were able to compose themselves, get together, and it shows a lot of character to be able to fight back like they did.
Here are the Eagles gaining possession here, trying to work it free, but Couturier in on net, can't gain full possession of the puck. They scramble for it to the right of the Salt Lake goal. Roadrunners try and dig it free. They fight for it to the right of the Salt Lake net. Now to the right wing point for McDonough, closing in. His shot off the backboards and wide. Actually was trying to pass it free. And finally the youngster McCosh for Phoenix. Here is the center iceman, flips it back of the Salt Lake net. Phoenix, Breslin centers one, but Hafey back checks beautifully and flips it to the blue line, but not out. Karjalainen steals. He lost the handle of the puck, and finally it squirts the center. A break for Salt Lake, and the Roadrunners dump it all the way down. Phoenix change up on the fly.
Well, they had a fierce forecheck going again against the Golden Eagles defenseman, and the Eagles really have to buy themselves some time deep in their own zone.
Here's Brent Thompson, the 20-year-old. Played last two seasons in the Western Hockey League with the Medicine Hat Tigers. Clears it all the way free. Guy for Solik in his second stint with the Golden Eagles. On the right side, cleared, and Norton shot steered aside by Mazzotti. Eagles having problems, as Randy mentioned, clearing it out of their own end. They're being bottled up right now as the Roadrunners gain possession. Phoenix along the boards to work it free, and finally Kozlowski backhands one for Deasley. He can't clear it out. The Eagles, all kinds of problems, and finally Harkins down the right side into the Phoenix zone, shoots, and a pad save made by Gilmore as the Harkins went for the short side, and now it's clear to center, and the Eagles Stoke, former Kansas City Blade, clears it to the defense, and the defenseman Norton able to cue it for O'Dwyer, and across the line, Ian Duncan shoots, and Mazzotti gets a stick on that, and it deflects wide. Eagles break back, wide open play. Here's Dennis Holland in his first Eagle season. In on goal, can't make a play, now holds on to the puck and centers one. Gilmore steers it aside. Here is Clark, who was a fan favorite here a couple of years ago. Back of the net, runs into Lands, loose into the far corner, and the former Bowling Green Falcon, Ian Duncan, on right wing. Clears but not out, Holland for Salt Lake. Plays for Melrose, in for Kerry Clark in his backhand, whirling around to the left of the goal. Clark for Salt Lake trying to center one. Man scrambled to the left of the Phoenix cage. They still try and fight for it as the period coming down to just over 2 minutes. They still try and go at the loose puck. Brad Watson says, keep it going, guys. And finally, after a while, they freeze it up. The score here in Phoenix, the Golden Eagles and the Roadrunners tied at 2. And we'll have more exciting play-by-play from the Coliseum in just a moment.
That's nice dinner music you got going there, Brian.
What's that?
Brian's got some nice dinner music on there.
Mike Barak alongside Randy Busick here in Phoenix. The Eagles and the Roadrunners tied at 2. Faceoff deep into the Phoenix zone. Eagles have Hafey with Struby, and Tim Harris is the forward line, but Chris Norton on defense. His first Roadrunner season, dumps it all the way down. The rookie Mazzotti plays it to the right of the goal, and Tim Harris backs it up for his own defense. Under 2 minutes to go here in the first period. We're tied at 2, and the goaltender himself, Gilmore, plays to center. And the Roadrunners gain possession. McDonald overskates. Hafey steals into the Roadrunner zone. Fires right on, and Gilmore covers up and makes the save as Hafey steaming down the left wing side.
Good job.
36 left in the opening period. A 2-2 tie. Good scoring chance for the Eagles. Rookie out of Michigan State.
Good job for Hafey to pick up that loose puck, and really can't make a mistake by throwing anything at Darryl Gilmore right now, because you got to remember, he hasn't played a lot this season. He's a little bit shaky right now, and you want to throw the sink at him because you never know what's going to go in.
Gilmore, a third-round Flyers pick back in 1985, his fifth-year professional. Played actually with former Golden Eagle Theron Fleury in the Western Hockey League. Here's a chance for Darren Stoke, and steered aside by Gilmore. Eagles center, another chance, and Kozlowski's shot is blocked off. And the Roadrunners gain possession. Scott Bukestad, former Minnesota North Star, scored over 40 goals one season with that team. Plays it behind the net for Couturier. Stoltz rides him off the puck. Man scramble, and finally the Eagles come up with the puck, but a lot of pushing and shoving to the right of the goal. It was Kevin Guy and Scott Bukestad along the far side to the right of the Salt Lake goal. 2-2 is our score here in Phoenix, the Eagles and the Roadrunners, and we'll come right back in just a moment. The things are heating up here in Phoenix.
Okay.
You want me to stay here, Brian?
Salt Lake Metal Team number 33, Kevin.
And once he gets there, I go down? All right. All right.
Salt Lake Metal Team number 33, Kevin Guy. 2 minutes holding, 18:47 of the first period.
Kevin Guy, who played in 1987-88 with Salt Lake's Turner Cup team, back with Salt Lake. He picks up a penalty, Randy. 2 minutes for holding at 18:47. Phoenix's fourth power play chance of the hockey game. And the faceoff control down to the left wing point. Rick Lyons now for Phoenix. Hands it for Francis Breaux to the near side. Breaux at the top of the circle. Being watched from this power play, drops it to the point for Lyons, holding on. Under a minute to go in the period. He's centering pass for Breaux, and Mazzotti gets a piece. Man scrambling, it's tipped away. Great scoring chance for Phoenix, and finally Salt Lake play it all the way down. Oh, that was close into the Salt Lake territory. Here's the puck loose on the right side. Eagles gain possession of the puck, and it's cleared on the right side. Roadrunners take over. Bukestad at the point. Flips it behind the net. It is loose the back of the goal. Phoenix now with 30 seconds to go in the period. Work it free. It is the forward O'Dwyer to the point. Chapdelaine fans on it. And right to Sean Afey. Says thank you very much and clears it all the way down. And the Roadrunners have to go back. 16 seconds to go in the period. Harris now back of the goal for Salt Lake. Fighting off with Chapdelaine. They try and freeze it there. 9 seconds to go in the period, and they finally do with 8 seconds left. A 2-2 tie, and the faceoff will be deep into the Phoenix zone. Eagles getting a break at the blue line as Hafey was able to clear it all the way down. Faceoff will be into the Phoenix zone as the Eagles in a forecheck on that last particular play into the Phoenix zone, and it was finally taken by the defenseman Norton to the right of the net. Here are the Roadrunners gaining possession on the left wing side. 3 seconds to go in the period. It's cleared to center and deep into the Salt Lake zone. And there you have it, a 2-2 tie at the end of 20 minutes of play. The Eagles and the Roadrunners. Exciting hockey here before a tremendous crowd at the Veterans Coliseum. Pair of goals for both teams. We'll have some exciting between periods activities. We'll be right back in just a moment.
Just bring it down to Mike Barrick at ringside. Welcome back to Phoenix, Arizona after the first period of play. The Salt Lake Golden Eagles and the Roadrunners tied up at 2, and what a great period we've had. A lot of great shots, and we're going to go down to Mike Barrick at ringside.
Hi, everybody, and this is Mike Barrick at the Veterans Coliseum in Phoenix, and I hope you enjoyed the first period. And wow, 4 goals, 2 for Salt Lake and 2 for the Roadrunners in a tremendous battle here at the Veterans Coliseum, and not too fun
Ryan.
For the goaltenders. Well, I think during our intermission, I think you really enjoy a feature that we did. A youngster from Salt Lake City making a mark in the collegiate ranks with the University of New Hampshire, Salt Lake native Jeff Levy.
It's not very often Salt Lake City can call one its very own in the sport of hockey, but Salt Lake native Jeff Levy may soon change all of that.
For Goodrow, here's Goodrow on a breakaway. He's in, and he's stopped by Levy.
You always wonder if you can make it coming from a place like Salt Lake City, not the biggest hockey country in the world, but little by little I moved up and I made my big step to juniors and then to college, and right now I'm still improving in college level, and I'm coming and I feel a better goaltender.
Jeff Levy is currently the starting goaltender for the University of New Hampshire Wildcats, a Division I hockey school in Durham, New Hampshire, having one of its best seasons in school history. Levy, a 21-year-old sophomore, has been instrumental in the team's success.
I mean, it's been like a dream even up to this point, my second year there. I'm still playing, and the team's improving. It's becoming a really good program, and it's fun.
What makes Levy's success story remarkable is that he played almost all of his amateur hockey in Salt Lake City, gaining in stature, but hardly a hockey hotbed in terms of player development to major college and the professional ranks. For 3 years, Levy played goal with Highland High, capping his junior season with a state championship over Brighton in 1988. After winning the state title, Levy elected to leave high school his senior year to pursue hockey opportunities in the United States Hockey League, an amateur developmental league in the state of Minnesota.
I met Jeff at a high school tournament in Chicago. Teams from all over the country were there. Jeff was playing on the Utah team and mentioned the hockey camp to him, and he joined us that very first summer of that league and gave up eight weeks of his summer just to work on all the things that are necessary to become a good hockey player.
After two successful seasons in the USHL, Levy was pursued by several major Division I college hockey schools. After weighing the options, Levy chose the unheralded UNH program. One Salt Lake personality very familiar with the University of New Hampshire is current Golden Eagle coach Bob Francis. Francis was part of the powerhouse Wildcat teams of the late 1970s, which won two championships in the ECAC. Francis electrified the crowds at Snively Arena in Durham with his dazzling play, and is well aware of Levy and his current success at that school.
Now Jeff is in a good position where he can continue his academic growth and get his education, hopefully, and make a decision from there. So that's the ideal predicament for a player at that age. I mean, years ago, the player, if he was capable of maybe going on to the pro, that he went to the junior route. But if it didn't work out, he had no education. I think Jeff made a wise decision going to the University of New Hampshire.
Levy's success has been profound. Last year, he was the Hockey East Rookie Goaltender of the Year, going 15-7-2 with a 3.22 goals against average. He also copped NCAA honors as a second-team All-American. But perhaps his greatest thrill was being drafted by the NHL's Minnesota North Stars as a seventh rounder in 1990, giving him hope of becoming the first native Salt Laker to reach the National Hockey League.
I was lucky to be drafted by Minnesota in the seventh round. Pretty high for a kid from Salt Lake.
Although Levy has a long way to go in reaching the National Hockey League, he is well on his way. And if things continue the way they have the past 5 years, Salt Lakers may well be calling Jeff Levy one of their very own.
And Jeff Levy's father, Jim, coached him at Highland High. And boy, what a story. Jeff Levy, a chance to make it to the National Hockey League. There are some other Salt Lake players that have played pro. Roger Ruggiero is currently playing in the East Coast Hockey League with the Nashville team. And former Eagle Eric Johnson was a star at Denver University and played with Salt Lake during the 1987-88 season. Hope you enjoyed the feature on Jeff Levy. What a hockey game we have here. A 2-2 tie between the Eagles and the Roadrunners, and we'll have more between various activities in just a moment. Was that okay?
Hey, what took you guys so long to get down here?
Did
you stop to go to the bathroom or what?
Okay. We don't have a monitor here anyway. We got important things to talk about.
Yep.
Okay.
Hey, you gotta get down there faster. Which way did you guys come?
Well, she went through the stairs.
Why didn't you come down the stairs?
No, we gotta go around, and it's fast.
There's stairs right down there, and you can come around.
It's what I suggested.
Is that what you suggested?
Yeah. Get you on camera there.
What do you want to talk about?
First period.
What do you want to say?
Wide open.
What were the shots on goal?
16-11.
Yes. Fair enough. Fair enough. We'll be here for about a minute and a half.
Okay.
Hey, there's only so much you can do with a radio face, so, you know, what can you do?
You want a 30-second?
He'll give it to me. Yes?
Do
You can tell.
Yes, Struby. We can't see it. You'll tell us when?
What's he doing? Well, let me in on it, eh?
Welcome back, everyone. This is Mike Barak here at the Veterans Coliseum, joined by former Golden Eagle Randy Busick. And Randy, boy, what a first period. Four goals scored. It was just a fabulous, exciting hockey game.
Well, we pretty well expected exactly what we got, Mike. Fast-paced, hard-checking, a lot of great chances, some good goaltending, and a 2-2 tie.
Boy, the Eagles started off well. Two goals early on. The Roadrunners coming back, scoring a power play goal. But anybody's hockey game at the end of 20 minutes of play. And Randy, that first goal, it was kind of a strange one. Todd Struby in front of the goal, and he flipped it home.
Well, it really was. He jumped in fast, got the rebound off the backboards, and was able to flip it high over Gilmore to give the Golden Eagles a 1-0 lead.
Todd Struby, in his first year with the Golden Eagles, signed as a free agent by the Flames this summer. And then the Golden Eagles scored again, but Phoenix came back and scored two in a row.
Well, Phoenix really didn't falter at all. They came back and fought hard and really turned this into a great contest.
Not too fun for the goaltenders, though, Randy. They don't like games like this.
Well, no doubt about that. They've had point-blank shots time and time again, and they've had to come up with some big saves. And if it weren't for the two goaltenders, we'd have a much higher scoring game than we have right now.
Well, we're 2-2 through 20 minutes of play. We'll come back with a CNN Sports Update in just a moment. 2-2, the Eagles and the Roadrunners here in Phoenix, and we'll be back with more in just a moment. Couldn't look better. Everything fine. Is that it?
Yeah, that's it. Nope, you're wait.
You go back up there now.
Jay, watch. Get that thing out of here. We need this one more time, though.
Yeah, I'm going to need it this time, okay?
Yeah, you got one more time, though.
Yeah, really, yeah.
After this. I don't know. I haven't heard anything about that.
Hello?
How much time do I have? Okay. Everything going okay? Okay. 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 No, it's that one we talked about. I have no clue. That's fine. No problem. No problem. Oh, no. I left my car down there. You gotta have... My card is down there. I left it down there. My broadcast card.
Oh, no.
Oh, shit.
Oh, no.
Oh, God.
Yep.
Hey, is this thing fixed yet or what? I can't hear it.
Welcome back, everyone. This is Mike Barak alongside Randy Busick here at the Veterans Coliseum in Phoenix, Arizona. And my, oh, my, what an exciting first period. Four goals, two for both teams. Struby and Deasley for Salt Lake. Breslin and Francis Bro for the Roadrunners. And we're deadlocked through 20 minutes of play.
Well, it certainly was exciting, Mike. The Roadrunners edged the Eagles in shots 16-11, but it was a great period.
Of course, the Eagles and the Roadrunners tied at 2, and we have some statistical information here tonight, Randy, sponsored by Paw Computers. And as we see a 2-2 tie, shots on goal 16-11 in favor of the Roadrunners.
But a lot of great forechecking in that period, and that's where most of the goals came from, was the big forecheck. And I'm sure that Bob Francis is going to be telling his team to try and hold up those Roadrunners and not let them get in so fast on the defensemen and let them make that play and clear the zone.
And one of the key statistics shown, the power play chances, 4 for Phoenix, none for Salt Lake. And no wonder it's a 2-2 tie, the Roadrunners scoring one of their goals with the man advantage.
Well, we talked about that at the start of the show, that discipline was going to be a big factor in tonight's game, and already the Roadrunners have had 4 chances, and they seem to be the ones that have really buckled down and are holding themselves disciplined and staying out of that penalty box.
The teams are on the ice, the Eagles and the Roadrunners. This building first housed the Roadrunners back in 1967. They played in the old Western Hockey League. They also had stints in the World Hockey Association, their star during that time, former Roadrunner Robbie Fatorik. They played briefly in the Central Hockey League and the now defunct Pacific Hockey League, joining the IHL 3 seasons ago, and this their first under the affiliation of the Los Angeles Kings, and they signed a long-term deal with Los Angeles this summer.
Well, it really has sparked a lot of interest here in Phoenix among the fans, and there you have a good look at the arena inside, and it really almost looks like the old Salt Palace. The fans are very tight close to the players and really get a good feel for the game and are very much a factor in the hockey game tonight.
Yeah, it's kind of a horseshoe on the outside, and inside they make a lot of noise, as you could hear during our first period, particularly when the Roadrunners scored to tie the game. Well, in the second period, the Eagles going from left to right. Hope you're enjoying the broadcast. And Randy, this is a lot of fun. I wish the fans could be here with us here in Phoenix, because we saw just a fabulous first period.
Well, it certainly is. And we talked about the rivalry, and I think that's something else that the fans have really come to appreciate, is this big rivalry between Salt Lake and Phoenix. And it's really carried over into tonight's contest also.
Golden Eagles here looking to increase the lead. We're tied, and to take the lead, and early on to start this period, they're shorthanded. Salt Lake's Kevin Guy went off for holding at 18:47. So the Eagles, one man short, and Sean Hafey with the Eagles shorthanded drops it back for Kevin Wertman, and Kevin Melrose immediately just spanks it all the way down into the Phoenix zone. And the Roadrunners try and tip it free, and the loose puck, Struby after it. But finally, Phoenix come up with a puck. It is Struby knocking down a Phoenix player, and another penalty coming up against Salt Lake. Brad Watson going to call a hook, and Bob Francis just has his arms folded at the Salt Lake players' bench. He's not too thrilled about that one.
Well, Struby got his stick caught in the arm of O'Dwyer, hauled him down, but I'm not too sure O'Dwyer may have helped him out a little bit here and took a little bit of a dive towards the end, and Watson saw that and decided to whistle him down for a penalty, putting the Golden Eagles now at a two-man disadvantage. Well, I tell you, they really got to start buckling down and stay out of that penalty box.
A total of 25 seconds gone. Todd Struby, who scored the first goal for Salt Lake, in the box for hooking, and the Roadrunners, as you mentioned, on a two-man power play. their second two-man advantage chance of the night. Still 22 seconds left in the guy infraction, and the Eagles with one forward and two defensemen.
Well, big kill here, and it could gain a lot of momentum for the Golden Eagles should they happen to kill this two-man advantage off.
And the Roadrunners gain possession. Rick lands at his own defense, a Czechoslovakian native. First round pick for Vancouver back in 1980, ahead for Francis Brault. In across the line, the Roadrunners lands at the blue line, able to play it free to O'Dwyer. DeLand shoots, and a kick save. Mazzotti, big rebound, and cleared away. It is O'Dwyer as the first player. Guy is back on a one-man Phoenix power play. Here's Lands now to Francis Brault. Flips it free into the corner. O'Dwyer trying to center one, but Solik cleared the zone and into the center ice area.
Good job by the Eagles to pick up that loose puck and gain a little bit of time for themselves by throwing it out of their own zone.
Here are the Roadrunners clearing it into the Salt Lake zone. Across the line is the dangerous Scott Bukestad. Hands to Rick Lands, shoots, and it's blocked off in front. Mazzotti may have gotten a piece of that. Lands now flips it for Norton at the top of the circle. Fires! That's off the stick of Guy, and it caroms wide to the blue line. But Lands artfully holds it in. His shot, and Mazzotti able to cover up with one white shirt in front. Bukestad able to hold on. Jason Mazzotti in net. The Eagles still have another 56 seconds to kill on this power play. Jason Mazzotti wearing number 36 for the Salt Lake Golden Eagles.
Well, for the most part, the defensemen in front of him are doing an outstanding job of boxing out the Roadrunners forwards and letting Mazzotti have a clear look at that puck. Boy, it makes things a lot easier for the goaltender when he can see what's coming at him.
One thing Mazzotti learned, he watched the San Diego Gulls pound off 9 goals against the Eagles in San Diego, and when he came in the next night, the Eagles won 3-2. He continuously pounced on top of the loose puck. Rather than give up a rebound, he would rather hold it and control it to set it up from fresh, and immediately the Eagles cleared all the way down.
Well, talking about Mazzotti, that's one thing. You're on the road. It doesn't have to be pretty. You just want to come out of here with a couple of points.
We have a 2-2 saw off, 18-14 left in the second period. And the Roadrunners work it free. Chapdelaine's long shot, caroms wide. Eagles play it, but not out. Roadrunners able to hold it in. Karjalainen trying to flip it free. Succeeds for the forward, Sean McCosh. Harris there, but to Karjalainen shoots, and it's deflected wide. Here are the Roadrunners with 19 seconds left on this power play. Couturier surveys the traffic. Hands for White, centers Couturier, but tipped away to the blue line. Held in by Phoenix. Chapdelaine. He's able to wind it into the corner. Grant for Salt Lake trying to dig it free. Harris in the far side. Plays for Karjalainen. Fires! That hits the Eagle defenseman Grant. He has no stick. Tries to throw it out, and he succeeds. How do you like that?
Boy, the fans are calling for a penalty there. Grant pulled that puck into his body and very close to a delay of game.
You can do that, however, on your own end. You can use your hand to deflect the puck out of your own side of the ice. You can't do that in the offensive zone, but when you're on your own side, it's legal. Here are the Roadrunners in across the line. Sean McCosh moving free, twirling around to the near hash marks. Eagles dig it free, and finally Deasley on left wing for Todd Harkins moving into the Phoenix zone. Can't get a good shot off, and Gilmore able to fall on top. Boy, Brent Thompson had him well checked all the way through. 17:01 left in the second. Eagles and the Roadrunners tied at 2, and we'll have more in just a moment. Mike Barak alongside Randy Busick from the Veterans Coliseum in Phoenix, Arizona. Glad you joined us here tonight. Face-off to the right of the Phoenix goal. Roadrunners 1-for-5 in the power play. The team's at even strength right now as it's cleared right back into the Salt Lake zone. Hustling back after Kevin Melrose. He played on a championship team in collegiate hockey with the Harvard University. Puck loose at center, and we're going to have a penalty on the play as you can hear the crashing against the boards on the far side. Kerry Clark and Brent Thompson, now Darren Banks and Thompson having some words into the Salt Lake zone.
Banks came into the boards hard, trying to forecheck on Thompson, got his arm wrapped around his head and almost pulled it right off. He really got his glove stuck in the upper area of Thompson, but he's going to go to the penalty box, probably for a two-minute minor, and again, Phoenix goes on the power play, and the Eagles put themselves in a shorthanded situation.
Darren Banks in the top five in penalty minutes in the IHL. Banks for Salt Lake is total this year of 138 minutes in penalties.
Banks goes into the boards hard with him, but he gets his glove up high, catches Thompson, spins him around, and Watson was right there. You can see him. He had a great look at it, and he called a penalty.
Well, they are discussing things into the center ice area. We'll have penalties. Banks in the box. A 2-2 tie here in Phoenix. The Eagles and the Roadrunners. And we'll take a break and come right back in just a moment.
Nothing. Derek's putting me to sleep, man.
Darren Banks in the box for Salt Lake. 2 minutes for roughing at 3:15. Banks now with 140 minutes in penalties. He is right among the leaders as far as that department is concerned. The sixth power play for Phoenix. They are 1-for-5 in the hockey game so far. Eagles have not had a man advantage chance. Here's the play in the slot. Roadrunners try and work it free, but finally it's cleared by Solak and all the way down. And the Eagles' penalty killing has been tested all night long, and they've done a nice job.
Well, they've had their work cut out for them, but they certainly came to compete tonight, and they're doing an excellent job so far in this game.
Eagles doing a nice job of clearing the zone whenever they gain possession shorthanded. And there's Wertman trying to flip it on the boards, but cleared by the Roadrunners and dumped right back into the far corner. Phoenix trying to work it free. It's worked to the left wing point, and Phoenix take over. Here is the play to the side of the goal. They try and dump it in front, but Melrose able to play it and outside the blue line. Roadrunners try to pass it free in the slot, but it went off the side of the net.
Trying to throw it across the crease. Very dangerous play. You got to watch the winger sliding down there, but Mazzotti was sharp. Bombs that puck into the corner and kept it out of harm's way.
Here's Sean White, 21-year-old Sudbury native at the right wing point for the defenseman. Lands to White. White being hounded by Olsen, and then it's deflected up into the stands with 15:36 to go in the second period. The Eagles and the Roadrunners squared up at 2 apiece. Eagles last year lost in 4 straight to the Roadrunners in postseason play, and a bitter disappointment for Bob Francis after a 50-win season for the Golden Eagles.
Well, no question. A very tough one to swallow there for Bobby Francis. Had his team rolling in February, but came playoff time, just ran out of a little bit of steam, and Phoenix was able to take advantage of that and take him in 4 straight.
They have a different team this year. Couturier back. He was a leader for this club last year. O'Dwyer was a force in the playoffs. Jeff Rolichek and Dave Pazine and a number of others have gone elsewhere, but this is still a very strong hockey team despite their 10-19-5 record. Face-off again, deep to the left of the goal. Real 14 presents the Lou Rawls Parade of Stars tomorrow evening. Both annual telethon for the benefit of the United Negro College Fund will feature performances by more than 40 of your favorite radio, TV, and movie stars. The program, originating from New York, Hollywood, and Washington, D.C., will air live on Real 14 from 4 to 7:30 and will continue on a tape-delayed basis after the Weber State University basketball game. Boy, that's a handful right there. Here's the play to the right wing point. Chapdelaine a drive, and Mazzotti makes the save. They drew it back to the right wing point. Chapdelaine, a seventh round Kings pick in 1986, but Mazzotti says no.
Well, great save by Mazzotti. I think that may have been tipped in front, and those are the hardest ones to stop. Mazzotti peeks behind him. He wasn't sure if that one squeaked behind him or not, but he's got a lot of traffic in front of him. A big tip right there, and he comes up with a big save.
Mazzotti from Toronto, Ontario, with Ken Dryden and Mike Liut as his goaltending idols. Not too shabby.
Well, when you have idols like that, and if you can perform half as well as they did, you're doing pretty good.
In fact, he grew up not too far from the Liut household in a suburb of Toronto. Immediately, the Eagles cleared all the way down, and the Roadrunners have to go back. And the Eagles still shorthanded for another 27 seconds. Banks still in the box. Roadrunners work it free in the center ice, but Kevin Guy spanks it all the way down. It goes on goal, and Gilmore sets it up for his own defense. And back after it is Kiosti Karjalainen for the Roadrunners. On the right side, Sean White into the Salt Lake zone. For Tim Breslin, shoots from a sharp angle, and it caroms to the right point. Chapdelaine unable to hold it in. Banks ready to come back on. Eagles have killed off the penalty. Roadrunners 1-for-6 here tonight.
Well, what a great job they've done so far, and that's been a big factor tonight.
Here's Couturier, rifles it wide of the target, and Salt Lake to take over. Here's Todd Harkins, leads it for Banks, rumbles into the Phoenix zone. He falls down, and McDonald levels him. Banks didn't like that. Then he takes a hit, and here we go. McDonald, Banks, and Kozlowski, the linesman, intercept. It's been quiet so far, but not when Darren Banks is in the middle of it.
Well, Couturier is going to get whistled down for the initial penalty, and they're going to try and draw one against Banks to even things up. But if the Eagles can just calm themselves down, they're going to go on their first power play tonight.
Banks playing tonight without a full face shield. He had a tooth knocked out and had 18 stitches in his facial area. But here tonight, he's going to play a little bit more with reckless abandon because he feels a little bit more free without that face shield.
Banks loses his footing as he goes into the corner. McDonald takes him hard, and then Couturier comes in and hits Banks from behind and gives him an extra shove right here, and I think that's where it's going to be called on the penalty. Couturier goes in for roughing, and now we finally get a chance to see the Golden Eagles on a power play.
Well, Banks, one of the rougher players in the IHL, as we all know, and not too many players want to go with big number 29.
Well, there's no doubt about that one, Mike. When you see somebody as big and imposing as him on the ice, you tend to shy away. But I think Ralph Backstrom has told his players, hey, perhaps here's a guy here that we can get him off his game a little bit, perhaps draw him into a penalty situation and put ourselves on a man advantage, so give him a little extra shove. He's going to retaliate, and that's usually what the referee's going to call.
Salt Lake ranked 9th on the power play, their first chance of the game. They're 23-for-162. Here's Workman, a shot steered aside and cleared by Phoenix in the center. The first power play chance of the night for Salt Lake. The Roadrunners have had 6 man advantage chances already. Man, the Eagles play at the center, but right intercepted into the neutral zone by Tim Breslin and cleared all the way back down. Eagles aren't used to having a power play here tonight, Randy.
Well, no doubt about that. A little bit rusty, but if they can get things together, it would be a big go-ahead goal for them.
Here's Kevin Wortman, who leads Salt Lake defenders in scoring, followed by Daryl Olsen, who's second. Wortman bangs it right back in. Here's Holland for Salt Lake, trying to work it for Sean Hafey. Mad scramble and finally cleared by Phoenix all the way down. A little bit of the Eagles' medicine here as the Roadrunners just dump into the Salt Lake zone.
Well, the Roadrunners have a very aggressive penalty-killing style. They don't sit back and let the Eagles set up. They go right after them and try and gain possession of that puck and throw it down the ice.
Eagles of Holland flanked by Hafey and Harkins on the power play as the Roadrunners try and work it free. Here are the Eagles. Harkins on the boards on left wing for Olsen at the blue line. Right side for Wortman. Here's Hafey to Wortman at the right point. Hands it for Hafey. Side of the goal for Dennis Holland. Here's Holland back to the right wing side. Wortman shoots and he just misses by a whisker at the left point. Third year Eagle defenseman Daryl Olsen trying to jam it free. It's cleared outside the blue line and all the way down.
Well, Bukestad was able to pick up an errant pass there off of Olsen's stick. Throw it down the ice and kill a little more time off of that clock. Only 25 seconds remaining in the penalty now.
2-2 our score, a 12:48 left in the middle stanza. Here's Corey Lyons, who's played sparingly tonight for Salt Lake. Here is Lyons in a forecheck, but cleared by Phoenix on the right side and outside the blue line. And again, the Roadrunners just dump all the way down into the Salt Lake zone.
Well, the Roadrunners are doing an excellent job of gaining that puck and beating the Golden Eagles to it and getting a chance to throw it down the ice.
Here's Melrose for Salt Lake. Able to arch to center. Dumps it on his backhand behind the net. Gilmore himself sets it up. That's it in the penalty. Eagles fail to score, but they wrap it in front. And it's steered aside. Lyons now for Struby. Breaking it up, however, is the Phoenix defender on the right side of McDonald trying to jam it free. Wait, Tim Harris levels McDonald. Lyons gives him a bump also. And finally, it's worked up the center ice and McCosh. Headbands for Breslin. Into the Salt Lake zone. Shoots it just wide. And it caroms to the blue line. And Tim Harris, for Salt Lake, the Eagles rookie, able to clear it in his center. And Tim Harris won an NCAA championship at Lake Superior. Here is the Grant on right wing. Lofts it right back into the Phoenix zone. And the Roadrunners gain possession out of their own side. 20-year-old Brent Thompson at center ice for the artful Carjalainen. In for the forward.